Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about classification of fungicides for plant disease management. We know fungicides are the chemicals which kill fungi. These fungicides are the backbones of chemical management of plant diseases. Most of the plant diseases are caused by fungi. So fungicides come to the rescue for quick management of diseases. Since long time, we have been using fungicides. So all the fungicides that we have developed till date can be classified. Classified based on several parameters. We will see here how we can classify the fungicides. For simplicity of understanding, we need to classify the fungicides. So, the basis of classification of fungicides are mobility in plant, general use. Based on general use, you can classify fungicides. Mode of action, site of inhibition in the target fungus, chemical nature. So, based on these factors, we can classify the fungicides that we have today. Based on mobility in plant, we can classify the fungicides into two major groups. One is systemic fungicide. They are called systemic because they enter into the plant system. They show apoplastic movement, works best when applied in the root zone because they can be taken up by the root and they can be translocated in the xylem vessel of the plant. And the site of action of these systemic fungicides may be away from the site of application. So for a foliar disease, if a systemic fungicide is applied in the root, it will work. Root will absorb the systemic fungicides and the fungicide will translocate, enter into the plant and translocate into the plant system and will be distributed in the plant, all plant parts, and will find the target fungus in the foliage and kill it. So systemic fungicides enter the plant. So there are many systemic fungicides that we'll see in the subsequent lectures which are being used these days. One very common systemic fungicide that we use today is carbendazime or Benomyl. Then non-systemic or contact fungicides. These fungicides act only at the site of application if comes in contact with the target fungus. So if the fungus is there in the soil, then we have to apply the fungicide, contact fungicide, on the soil. If the fungus is present on the leaf surface or foliage, then we have to apply the contact fungicide which is inhibitory to that pathogen on the leaf surface only. So here the contact fungicide does not enter into the plant. There are many contact fungicides like mancozeb, commonly used contact fungicide. Then we have copper oxychloride, another very commonly used contact fungicide. Then another type of fungicide based on mobility can be locally systemic fungicide. Strobilurin fungicides are basically locally systemic fungicides. They are recently developed fungicides. They show locally systemic action. Now, what are the differences between contact and systemic fungicides? The contact fungicides are preventative, whereas systemic fungicides are preventative and curative. Locally systemic fungicides are preventative. Contact fungicides are multi-site inhibitors. They inhibit multiple functions in the target fungus. Systemic fungicides are mostly single-site inhibitors. They inhibit one action, one target site. They inhibit only one metabolic pathway in the target fungus. Locally systemic fungicides are also single site inhibitors. Contact fungicides have less risk of resistance development because they are multi-site inhibitors. Pathogens find very difficult to overcome the resistance because there are many sites which are inhibited by the contact fungicide in the target fungus. Whereas systemic fungicides and locally systemic fungicides, they pose more risk of resistance development because they are single site inhibitors. For contact fungicides, we need higher doses. For systemic fungicides, we need lower dose. Locally systemic fungicide also, we need lower dose because they enter the plant and get translocated in the plant system. Contact fungicides require more number of applications. Systemic fungicides require less number of applications. Frequency of application is less for systemic fungicides. For locally systemic fungicides, moderate number of applications are required. Residual toxicity is low for contact fungicides and it is medium to high for systemic fungicides and it is low to medium for locally systemic fungicides. Examples, contact fungicides are those, as we said earlier also, mancozeb, Bordeaux mixture, copper oxychloride, thyram, these are contact fungicides, very commonly used. Here, Bordeaux mixture is the first discovered fungicide. Systemic fungicide, carbendazime, carboxine, these are systemic fungicides. Carboxine is the first discovered systemic fungicide. Locally systemic fungicides are the strobilurin fungicides. Strobilurin fungicides are obtained from, originally they were obtained from a mushroom called Strobilurus. From there, the chemical was taken and it was modified and synthesized chemically, and we got several kinds of strobilurin fungicides that we use today. So these fungicides are locally systemic fungicides. There are some terms. We must know these terms in order to understand mobility of fungicide inside the plant. Translaminar movement. Translaminar movement means here the fungicide molecule moves from one side of leaf lamina to the other side, like strobilurin fungicides. If these fungicides are applied on the upper surface of the leaf, then the fungicide molecules will move to the other side of the leaf, that is lower surface of the leaf. So that is called translaminar movement. Movement across the leaf lamina to reach the other side. These translaminar movements are shown by strobilurin fungicides. That's why they are called as locally systemic fungicides. Then we have apoplastic movement and symplastic movement. Apoplastic movement occurs in the dead part of the tissue where there is no cytoplasm involved, like xylem movement. Systemic fungicides mostly show apoplastic movement, that is, they are xylem mobile. Symplastic movement, which occurs through phloem or living part of the cell. So apoplastic and symplastic, these two movements we should know for understanding the differences in mobility of fungicides. Now, based on general use, fungicides can be categorized as seed protectants like Captan, Thyram, very commonly used seed treating fungicides, Captan and Thyram. Then soil fungicides like formaldehyde, Vapam, they are all fumigants. They are used for treating the soil to kill the plant pathogenic fungi which are present in the soil in the form of spores, in the form of resting structures. Then foliage protectants like Farbam, Zinab, Mancozeb, fruit protectants like Captan, Manab, eradicants like lime sulfur, tree wound dressing fungicide like Bordeaux paste. So based on general use, we can say that these are the terms associated with fungicides: seed protectants, soil fungicide, foliage protectants, fruit protectants, eradicants, and wound dressing fungicides. Based on mode of action: protectants, therapeutants or curative, and eradicants. The protectants, they prevent infection. The fungicides which prevent infection remain on the leaf surface, which have contact action, but they are a little bit phytotoxic. They are multi-site inhibitors, naturally, because they are contact fungicides, so they will be multi-site inhibitors. And they have to be applied before infection occurs. Then only they will be protecting the plant. Whereas eradicants, in contrast to the term protectant fungicides, eradicant fungicides, they control existing infection. They are xylem mobile, that means they are systemic. They have apoplastic movement. They are not phytotoxic. They are single site inhibitors. Now here, we can see in this illustration, protectants which are applied before infection and after symptom development, that means infection has taken place already, we need curative fungicides to cure the plant. We also need a different category of fungicide like curative or eradicant when the fungus established infection and it is multiplying in the plant, it is sporulating in the plant. So before infection occurs, we need protectants. When infection occurs, we may go for curative fungicides. And when the disease has developed so much and the pathogen is sporulating, we'll require curative or eradicant. So this simple illustration helps us to understand when we require which fungicide. But we know the general rule, the thumb rule of disease management is that prevention is better than cure. So, in order to prevent infection, we will require protectants, we'll require the contact fungicides, which will remain on the leaf surface and prevent infection. So the protectants which are there on the leaf surface will protect the plant against any future invasion by the fungal pathogen. Curatives, they will cure the plant of infection which has already taken place. And in case of transliminal fungicides, what we see that if you apply the fungicide on the upper surface and your spore or the pathogen is there on the lower surface, then the translaminar movement will happen and then the spore on the other side will be killed. Based on site of inhibition in target fungus, fungicides can also be grouped as mitochondrial electron transfer chain ETC inhibitors, nucleic acid synthesis inhibitors, cell division inhibitors, protein synthesis inhibitors, lipid synthesis inhibitors, sterol biosynthesis inhibitors, melanin biosynthesis inhibitors. In some other lectures, we'll discuss with examples how these groups of fungicides, where and in which fungus the fungicides attack. In some other lectures, subsequent lectures, we'll see with examples, the fungicides which inhibit different target sites in the fungus. Like which fungicides inhibit electron transfer chain, which fungicides inhibit cell division of the fungi, or sterol biosynthesis inhibitors. They are SBI fungicides which inhibit sterol biosynthesis. So we'll see with examples. This lecture is basically classifying on the basis of certain parameters. Based on chemical nature, the fungicides can be grouped into sulfur fungicides, copper fungicides, benzimidazole, morpholine, acylalanines, imidazole, pyrimidines, triazoles, strobilurins, etc. There are hundreds of chemicals which are there being used as fungicide. So we can name all the groups, chemical groups here. We'll subsequently know in other lectures, in other YouTube videos, that what are the chemical natures of various fungicides and their modes of actions. So this is in brief classifying fungicides based on certain factors. So thank you very much. If you have any query related to this video, you can write to me in the comment box. Thank you again.